Hello everyone, I am Dr. Ishrat Sheikh from Avida Inamdar Senior College, and today I am going to discuss about rice weevil, that is Scythophilus oryzae. It is a very destructive stored grain pest. So we will be talking about marks of identification, life cycle, nature of damage and control measures of rice weevil. Introduction. Scientific name is Scythophilus oryzae. Distribution. Originally it is from India, but it is found all over the world. Nowadays most of the pests or other insects are being transported from one country to another along with food grains or human movement. Host complex. Scythophilus oryzae is found in the rice field and in the stored rice. It infests and destroys almost all cereals such as rice, wheat, jowar, sorghum, bajra, etc. and pulses, cowpea, Bengal gram, green gram, red gram, peas, our green peas. Okay, so it destroys almost all types of grains. So this is the picture showing marks of identification of rice weevil. You can see the protruded snout, then antenna, body black brown color. At some places you can see white powder, that is the rice powder in which the weevil was present. Then orange red spot is present on the elytra in a cross manner. So at four places you can see it. So 1, 2, 3, and 4. So it forms a cross. So at four corners of the cross you can see this orange red spot on the elytra. The first point that we are going to discuss about rice weevil is marks of identification, that is how looking externally you can identify that it is rice weevil. The adults measure 3 to 4.6 millimeter in length. Snout is long, slender and projecting downwards. The color of the body is brown to black, with four orange red spots arranged in a cross on the elytra. Adults have well developed wings and can fly. Adults, when disturbed, find death. Rice and maize weevils have very minor difference on the genitalia and they can hybridize. Let us see a video where the rice weevil is find death. The second point about rice weevil is its life cycle. Life cycle of rice weevil shows complete metamorphosis. It is a holometabolous insect, so all four stages, that is egg, larva, pupa and adult, are observed. So first stage is the egg stage. Females lay 2 to 6 eggs per day and they can lay up to 300 to 500 eggs in their lifetime. The female deposits a single egg within the hole of a grain. So the female chews the grain, makes a hole and lays a egg. So one egg in the hole of one grain, and then she seals it with the secretions from her ovipositor. So this is a safety measure to see that the eggs do not fall away from the rice or any other cereal or pulse grain, whatever it is. Eggs are small, oval and white in color. Size of the egg is 0.7 millimeter in length and 0.3 millimeter in width. Incubation time is 4 to 9 days. Incubation period varies because of variation in the environmental conditions such as temperature and humidity. The second stage in the life cycle is the larval stage. The newly hatched larva or the grub is very small in size, body is soft, fleshy, creamy white, dirty white or yellowish white in color. Head is dark brown. It is voracious feeder. It develops within the grain, feeding on the kernel and making the seed hollow. And it grows to its maximum size in 19 to 34 days. So here in this diagram, you can see a rice grain, and inside which, in the hole of the grain, you can see the grub. Its head is brownish in color. Mouth parts are brown. The third stage is the pupa or the pupal stage. Pupa in Latin means doll, and pupae is its plural. So fully grown larva pupates within the grain. Pupae is small and dirty white initially, but later on it becomes brown and finally black. In favorable condition, the pupal period is of 3 to 6 days, while under unfavorable condition, it may last up to 10 to 20 days. Adult. An adult eclodes from the pupal case and comes out of the rice grain. Eclode means the process of emerging from the pupal case. It is called as eclosion. The adult lives for 4 to 5 months, even for 2 years. Males produce an aggregation pheromone, cetophyllar. Synthetic cetophyllar attracts rice weevils, maize weevils and grain weevils. Female also produces sex pheromone. So this is the life cycle of rice weevil represented diagrammatically. You can see here small egg, then larva within the rice grain, pupa within the rice grain. Then after 10 to 20 days, pupa will be converted into adult rice weevil. This adult rice weevil will live for 4 to 5 months and lay eggs. And the eggs will hatch in 4 to 9 days and you get the larvae, and in this way the life cycle continues. Now the third point about rice weevil is nature of damage. Both adults and larvae are voracious feeders, but the larvae are more destructive. They feed on the kernel and leave behind hollow grains. Such seeds are not edible. They do not germinate and they cause tremendous loss, not only to the farmers, but also to those people who have stored it in their home. Now let us watch a video showing the destruction caused by rice weevil on peas. Control measures. Various control measures are there. So first is the preventive measures that we can take at our home. Placing of dried neem leaves in the grains. Many people also use castor apple leaves, dried castor apple leaves, and they place it in the grains. Then coating the grains with castor oil or any vegetable oil. So what is usually done is, in many households you will find that in the summer season they purchase the whole stock of the year. So tur dal, moong dal, then rice, wheat, everything they purchase at one go for the whole year and store it. So what they do, they apply oil in their palms and rub it on the grains. So in this way, whole grain is coated with vegetable oil or castor oil. Usually it acts as repellent and it prevents the infestation by rice weevil and other stored grain pests as well. Then using of fresh bags for storing. Sun dry the grains before storage so as to completely remove the moisture content. Remove all potentially infested food sources, because if even a single jar is there which is having infestation, then somehow or the other they will move from there and enter into the another jar which is in good condition. Therefore, one should also use airtight bins, containers for storage. Then the second method of controlling is mechanical control. Infested grains should be sieved and sun-dried. The storehouse or store bins should be clean and damp-proof. Freezing of the infested food below minus 18 degrees centigrade for a period of 3 days is quite effective. So this controls the movement of the rice weevil. So whatever larvae or adult are there in the rice or any other grain which is infested by rice weevil, then they will be frozen. It is as good as going into hibernation and they will not destroy the grain. Then heating to 60 degrees centigrade for a period of 15 minutes is quite effective because it kills all the stages of the insect, egg, larva, pupa and adult. And therefore storing after heating under normal conditions is also possible. Then the third method is chemical control, the most popular method. Here you can mix 5% BSC to the grains. Spray the godowns with 0.4% BSC or DDT before storage. Fumigation of old bags and godowns which are empty with EDBR before storing new harvested grains is quite effective in controlling rice weevil. So we end up with our discussion on rice weevil, where we talked about identification marks, life cycle, nature of damage, and control measures.